Tauan, Kaas here, and the world is finally opening up again. At least over here, we're finally transitioning from having nothing to do at all outside to having stuff to do. I'm curious what the current state is for you over there, so let me know in the comments below. But because of this, I'm thinking of bringing my Quest 2 with me to friends again to show them the wonderful world of VR. But to VR newcomers, you really cannot drop them in every game you can think of. It's just very intense to drop them straight away in a game like Population 1. It's just not a good idea. So here's a list of my top recommendations of games to show off to friends and family. You can even use this specific order if you want. If you haven't yet, consider subscribing for more VR content, and now join me beyond reality after a quick message from today's sponsor. If you wear glasses, I highly recommend getting these prescription lens adapters for your VR headset, because glasses can potentially scratch your lenses and it reduces your field of view. Lens adapters protect you against that and still gives you the clarity you deserve. I'm a fan of these adapters from VR Wave, as they are good quality and well designed so that you can attach them to the lenses quickly. Cherry used these adapters and she adores them because of their magnetic design, allowing her to easily remove them when she shares her headset with friends or me. So you can get these lens adapters for your Oculus Quest 2, but also other VR headsets such as HP Reverb G2 or Valve Index. You can get them with or without a prescription, and you can add options like a blue light filter to make it easier on your eyes. Click on the link in the description to order one. VR Wave ships worldwide and it will take about 2 weeks. Now, let's get started. Number 1.
Roller coaster game.
I'm just kidding. Please don't start with roller coaster games. As much fun as it will be putting your friend through that, it will make them motion sick and they will think VR isn't something for them. That's not what we want, because the goal here is to make them a VR lover too, so that they can play with you next time, right? So when showing VR to people who never tried it before, my advice is to start with games that don't require any in-game walking. So games where you stand in one spot, or games that scale with your room that allow you to move around in real life. And then slowly we can transition them to a game with teleportation, and after that maybe the mild intense games. And this is also how I've built today's list too, in that order. So let's start with the real number 1, Ratchet & Clank Experience. My favorite way to show off VR, as it quickly shows how immersive VR can be. In this game, you basically enter an elevator and go like 500 floors up, and once the doors open, there's only a plank that you can walk on. This is where it gets fun. Everyone experiences this differently, but almost always, people do not expect it to feel so realistic. I've had people freeze up, some scream, one of my friends even jumped down, fell on the floor, then cried. I don't think she likes me anymore. I'm just kidding, she's fine. Anyways, if you decide on getting this game, make sure to buy a real plank, because you can clone that into the game, which makes it even more real. You do need some space for this, but trust me, it is worth it. Then next on the list are more games that don't have locomotion. Try out Blasten, for example. It's a competitive slow motion bullet hell where you duck, dodge and weave to evade incoming attacks from your opponent on the other side. Around you, some weapons randomly spawn, each with her own special skills. So it's up to you to decide quickly and be tactical. You'll break a sweat for sure, so it's also a good showcase of how VR can make you stay active and keep people healthy without even realizing. Talking about keeping active, these two games you cannot miss is of course Beat Saber, you know, that game that has you slash boxes on the beat of the music. I don't think this game needs any more explanation, right? Same goes for Pistol Whip, another music game, except instead of an arm workout, you get a lot more leg action, which is excellent. You use pistols to defend yourself in this game against enemies that come at you with bullets on the beat of the music. This one features more EDM music, while Beat Saber has more different artists. Online, you can give it a listen before you get the game, which I recommend doing. Both of these music games are fun for parties, because you can stream them on TV to get music in the background while others watch with some booze. It's super cozy. Super Hot VR is also one not to miss. This is the Matrix style game where time moves when you move. Strategize with that as it's up to you to defeat the Red Diamond Man. Since the game doesn't have locomotion, it is super comfortable. Still, it's one of those games making people feel totally bad, so I highly recommend getting this game for newcomers. Next, you could try out one of these games that simulates sports games. 11 Table Tennis for realistic table tennis, Top Golf with Pro Putt for golfing, and 4 VR Bowl for bowling. The last two games do require your friend to move around in-game, but it's by teleportation, so it's still comfortable. If you're having a party, the bowling title even has a pass-around mode for up to 8 players, which is a ton of fun. I mean, it's like having your own bowling alley at home. These are the kind of games that people will recognize, and it will usually amaze them that a $300 headset makes it possible for them to do these things at home. This is also the kind of marketing Oculus is using online, which is pretty funny. But I digress. There are a few more chill games without movement I recommend. Pick one of your choosing depending on what your friend likes. Open Brush is a free Dilt Brush clone and it lets you paint in 3D space. This is for the arty creative friends. It's free now because Google open sourced the code instead of shutting it down this year. So don't buy the original version if you don't have it yet. Just get this one available on App Lab. I've linked it below. Dilt Brush is one of the first games I've tried on a consumer VR headset too, and it's completely sold VR to me, so maybe it can do that for your friend as well. Fingers crossed. Then I recommend Bonfire for those who like movies. This is an interactive animated short where you're a space scout on a mission to discover a new home for the human race. However, you crash land on a mysterious planet where you meet these cute aliens. It's a super comfortable experience as you mostly watch, yet there are interactive things to do which showcases the power of VR. But what I think makes this great is the incredibly charming characters that come alive and it makes you feel like you're really there making friends. Then, continuing the movie lovers category, it's also fun to show off big screen VR as that's like having a movie theater inside your house. You can watch any videos or movies in 3D or without on a huge screen together with other people or alone in this app. It's also a free app and it includes free TV channels. Then I think after going through a few of the previously mentioned games, we can move on to games that pose a bit more challenge, like the third-person platformer Moss, where you control a little mouse on a mission to save the world. This game makes excellent use of the power of VR as you, as the player, helps the mouse out by manipulating the environment. You will solve puzzles together. It's an incredibly comfortable game, yet it is so, so good. Let's also move on to games with locomotion. My advice is to start with games that use teleportation first, as it's just more comfortable. Start with Elixir. This is a hand-tracking game where you become a sorceress apprentice. It's made by Facebook as a demo for hand-tracking, so it's free and short, which is of course perfect for showing off VR. I like showing this experience as newcomers usually find it pretty magical seeing their hands tracked. As you learn magic in the game, your hands also change colors and into weird things, which is a strange feeling, but strangely, that kind of sells VR when it can make you feel weird. Or am I weird for thinking that? Let me know if you agree with a thumbs up. Here's another magical experience that doesn't have anything to do with magic, but when I show people VR, there's one request I get a lot, especially from non-gamers. The question is, can you just take me to a beautiful place, just something I can escape to? Well, then good news, because there is a perfect game for that, which is National Geographic Explore VR. In this game, you set off as an explorer and you discover two iconic places, Antarctica and Machu Picchu in Peru. I recommended this one because the developers did a fantastic job capturing the environment realistically and giving it depth. It's insanely beautiful and it makes you feel awe when you're there. You have some freedom to teleport around too, and a guide will explain stuff stuff about the place, so it's also educational. Once you think your friends are ready, you can move on to a bit more intense games. My advice is to start with these titles first. First, Creed Rise to Glory, a boxing fighting game with stamina mechanics. So it's not only about who can drop the most punches, but it requires some gaming skill. Still, it's able to get a sweat out. People usually get a good laugh when they try to punch virtual people. Just make sure you have enough space for them to reach out, as new people typically do not notice guardians. The Climb 2 is a great one as well, as it's easy to understand. You just climb higher until you reach the goal. There's a casual mode where you can turn off the more complex mechanics like chalking your hands. I recommend turning this mode on for your friends. Another great title, in my opinion, that sells the power of VR is Phantom Covert Ops. In this game, you play as an elite covert op on a stealth mission. All of the game is played in a kayak, so you actually have to paddle to move around. I highly recommend having the player seated, as it makes it realistic and comfortable. Okay, last title, and you may not expect this, but I think this title is fun, especially if you're having a party with a group. I'm talking about Five Nights at Freddy's Help Wanted. Let me explain. First, it's a really easy to understand game. It has no locomotion. Most of what you do in game is look around while doing easy tasks like pressing buttons. It's a fun game to just pass around and play without any explanation to see who can get through the levels without screaming. I've played this game at a party with friends before, and we just had such a great time and great laugh, so this is why I'm recommending it. That's it for this list. Getting people into VR isn't easy, as you can tell. There's just so much more to consider than flat gaming. I've done it for 4 or 5 years now, and I have kind of a specific method now, so I wanted to share some last tips. When you are just handing the controllers over, make sure you create a guardian first, then walk out of the guardian and give the headset to the one playing. This way, the best true is activated when your friend wears the headset, so they can still see you and it's easy to give them the controllers. After you strap them in, help them move inside the guardian, as it will look like they just entered a portal into a new world. I love doing this, as people find this magical usually. Then, one more tip for your non-gamer friends. They usually do not know the mapping of the controllers. They do not know what a joystick is or what the trigger button is. I've had people hold the controllers like this. So make sure before you give them the headset, you show them what buttons there are on the controllers and also how to hold them first. Now, if you're showcasing VR, especially to women, you have to make them feel safe too. I mean, when they wear the headset, they become very self-aware that people can see them, but they cannot see others. So always say out loud when you're going to touch them, to move them around or something else. Just do not surprise them. But once you know they are good though, you can move on to your favorite intense games. Like, I like to show off The Walking Dead: Saints and Sinners. Now, you made your friend a VR enthusiast. Congratulations. I hope they will buy a VR headset now so that you can play together. Oh, don't forget them to get them to subscribe to us too then, you know, as support. Thanks for watching. A special thanks go to our champions, especially these patrons down below. One on, VR on.